Hello, fellow tankers. This is Dauntless, and welcome to 2 Cents. Today, I just wanted to take the time to show you guys what Wargaming have in store for World of Tanks in the near future. And as you can see, it is HD maps, and I feel like this is extremely long overdue, and I'm super excited that Wargaming have finally decided to implement this. And, you know, personally, I feel like the reason why they haven't done this, you know, they probably would have done this, you know, years ago, but a lot of computers probably couldn't have handled it. And so I feel like either Wargaming was waiting for, you know, the graphics to get to a point where even the old computers could handle this, because, you know, technology advances at a certain rate per year. And in this day and age, you know, a computer that's considered old, that's a few years old, could actually handle this, versus, you know, back in, let's say, 2015, and people using computers from 2012, their computers would have just had no way of handling this kind of graphics. So anyway, I think that's probably why. And another reason is because it's a Russian-based game, and a lot of people in Russia apparently have really bad computers, and they can't afford, you know, nicer things, I guess. So because of that, I feel like Wargaming are finally at a stage where they can say that, okay, let's start implementing these HD maps, because computers, you know, in general will be able to handle this. And the first thing I noticed when I started watching this video is the fact that the render distance has been increased greatly, to where you can actually appreciate the surroundings of everything around you. Like, look at the detail that they put into those mountains out in the distance. That gives me a much greater appreciation for the beauty of each map that they currently have implemented into this game. And this this video is going to go over 3 maps. It's going to have Mountain Pass, which you're seeing now. It's also going to have Redshire, and then Himmelsdorf at the very end. And it'll give you kind of a taste of 3 different kinds of maps. And, you know, obviously we can't see all the maps because Wargaming haven't put them into the game yet, but just the details that you can see in the distance really gives you a feel for the dynamic. And the color contrast has also been greatly improved. It doesn't have that kind of dull, murky gray and brown look that a lot of maps have. It's very, very bright and vibrant. And check out the quality of that water. And with that great draw distance that they have implemented into the game now, with all the, you know, the detail that you see in the distance, it kind of feels like you're actually in the location, instead of kind of being put in this little arena versus all these other tanks and forced to fight it out. It actually feels like a real life environment where you're in battle, and it, I think it's going to add just a lot more dynamic to the game and the quality and just the ambiance, I guess, of the whole experience of playing in World of Tanks. And I'm personally super excited about these changes. Alright, so the next map we'll be taking a look at is Redshire, and would you look at those colors? I'm a sucker for autumn, for colors. I actually do photography, so when I see those reds and oranges, I get all excited. But just look at the level of detail and vibrance that this map has. It just doesn't even feel like the old Redshire. Like, I hardly actually recognized what map this was until I looked at the mini-map and realized, like, crap, this is Redshire, and maybe that's where it got its name, because it's more red. Who knows? But just look at the vastness of this map. Like, really? It doesn't look like the old Redshire at all, and I think Wargaming did an incredible job detailing out this map. Obviously, some of their little mechanics that they've implemented with all this rubble and stuff bouncing off the tank could use a little bit work, and obviously it is a work in progress, but just take a look at that scenery. It looks like you could just drive your tank for miles and miles into the distance, when in reality the little line that you can't cross is just, you know, just right down the hill there. But I'm super excited for this, because this just gives you a real appreciation for the beauty of the map and the atmosphere of the game. And I really feel like this is just, again, going to add so much more to the game. And a lot more, I don't know, because Wargaming is doing this much with the graphics, I feel like they can actually push the envelope a little bit more. And actually, you know, they have maps that are this big now. They could easily increase the radius that you could drive your tank, and have more epic 30 versus 30 battles that they're starting to implement now. And because Wargaming has implemented that, as well as these HD maps, I feel like in the near future, we're probably going to start seeing more of those epic battle maps that they're going to start creating, as computers will be able to become more powerful and handle all these scenarios. Taking a look at these maps, I do realize that Wargaming has changed not just the quality and of texture and remade everything into HD, but they actually did change the maps quite a bit. I mean, not to an extreme to where you wouldn't feel familiar enough to play a lot of these maps, but they did change a lot of the terrain, and because of that, I may end up having to remake all my scout guides, which is kind of unfortunate because it did take a lot of time making them, but I guess, you know, everything is bound to change at some point. But I think it's really cool because, I mean, check out this castle. It actually looks like a castle and not just a random slab of rock that Wargaming just threw up in the map for a piece of cover. And, you know, look at this. This trench actually looks like you could fall off and flip your tank instead of just some random crater in the map. The level of detail, again, is incredible, and I'm really excited to see the rest of the maps and what Wargaming can actually do with them to give it their kind of their own atmosphere. So it doesn't feel like, oh, this map again, you know, or logging into the same feeling type of map over and over and over again, whereas every map is going to have a unique characteristic. Like this map obviously kind of feels like autumn, and it'll give each map its own flavor and its own excitement and beauty. And again, super excited and really looking forward to this. Wargaming definitely has taken the liberty to be a little bit creative with these maps, and I think the developers are having a little bit of fun because, you know, it's been a really long time before some of these maps have had some love. And check it out, this giant blimp has been crashed, and it's not just a model of a blimp that they just randomly broke up and sat here. Like, there is a lot of detail that has gone into this. There's actually pieces of cloth that are swaying in the wind. There's smoke and there's fire. And again, this adds just so much character to the map that I really feel like people are gonna just, I don't know, appreciate this game more than they already do. I think PC has lagged enough compared to its consoles, you know, equivalent. And this, I think, will just make it so much more competitive in terms of the gaming market. All right, so the next map we're going to be looking at is Himmelsdorf, and would you look at the level of detail they put into the surroundings of this map? No more are we going to feel like we're confined in this little tiny box of a city. You can actually look out into the water and see burning boats, and you can see the village in the background with the mountains and the ominous clouds, and it looks like a city that has seen war. It really does, and it just gives this map so much dynamic. And look at the rubble that's breaking on top of the tank. Just look at the level of detail and the mechanics that Wargaming have implemented, and again, it just makes it look and feel like a completely different game. Like, you hardly even recognize this, and it makes the old game look like something we would have played back in 2009 when this game was released, which, you know, I guess maybe it kind of you know, these maps have hardly seen any love since the game released, and it is really due time. And just because it's been so long since these maps have been upgraded, that, you know, I think that's the reason why it just looks and feels so different. Like, look at the quality of the terrain that we're driving over, with just even the grass and everything like that. It just feels and looks so different and fresh, and it's a much, much needed change. And again, I'm really, really excited for this. I hardly even recognize this map anymore because of the level of detail that they put into the surroundings. And, you know, you can just see the water moving to the side of the map. And obviously you can't go there, but Wargaming was very creative in the way they decided to block off the areas of the map that are accessible. And again, it's not just some giant wall they put up, you know, it's very, very detailed, very well thought of and planned out, and it just looks so gorgeous. I can't stress it enough. Wargaming did an outstanding job doing this, and just check it out. Do you recognize this? Before, you'd be driving up against a bunch of houses, and now you get to enjoy this sunset, or I guess sunrise, either, or driving up this what looks like train tracks or trolley tracks, and you're going up this hill, and clearly the mechanics of the, like, the breakable objects could use a little work because we have a couple giant sticks jammed out of our leopard here. But other than that, I mean, it actually looks like this castle took some artillery, and there's just giant chunks of rubble everywhere, and it's just so gorgeous. It really just has so much character, and I know I just sound like a radio, a broken record, right? Just on repeat, just talking so much about it. And I wish I could show you something, you know, I wish we could experience this actually in-game, because I think the level of detail would be so much better and the color is so much more vibrant. But because this is a video that I'm talking about and it wasn't rendered at a super high quality, we can't really appreciate the beauty in, you know, that's actually here. But I think everyone should be super excited for this, because I think that when all the maps are redone like this, it's just gonna change the game, and it's gonna be incredible. And check it out. Look at that view. Doesn't it look like somewhere you want to go brawl tanks in? You know, you see thunder, you can see, I don't know, looks like gunfire down below, and you can just see forever. And again, I'm super excited about these changes. So anyway, enough about me trying to hype up this game. I'm not being paid by Wargaming to tell you this. I just personally have been playing this game since open beta, and I've seen this, you know, game change throughout the years, and this is the most excited I've been about this game in a long time, and I really just wanted to share that with you guys. So anyway, if you thought this was cool and if you like the content, I'd really appreciate it if you get a like down below. And if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel for more content like this in the future. As always, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys later.